Welcome back to another edition of Vikings Film Room, brought to you by the Vikings Entertainment Network. I'm your host, Pete Bursich. Now, through some rare NFL scheduling quirk, the Seattle Seahawks actually come here to U.S. Bank Stadium to play a regular season game. Now, when that charter lands, it's going to be full of a lot of the same names. You got Russell Wilson, DK Metcalf, Tyler Lockett. Let's take a look at the film and see what that offense still brings to the table and what our offense is going to need to do to take advantage of the Seattle defense. Okay, the first thing you'll notice, again, Tyler Lockett, DK Metcalf, Chris Carson, a lot of familiar names. Don't forget about Russell Wilson, but Chris Carson's big in this. You have to stop the run or else Seattle will be able to do things like this to you. Now, you see Tennessee, they've got a lot of guys all around the line of scrimmage to try to stop the run. And just like we do, Seattle's going to try to take advantage of this. So they'll go off the play fake. He sets up, and now we have a one-on-one right here with Tyler Lockett and the safety with a lot of room up top. And Russell Wilson will take this all day long, delivers a perfect ball over the shoulder. Lockett comes down with it. So you want to pressure Russell Wilson, you say. Well, the Colts have him almost into the red zone. This is going to end up being an all-out blitz. They are going to send everybody they can, but the problem you have is now you've created a one-on-one in this situation, and the safety doesn't know if Lockett's going to go this way or if he's going to go this way. There's just too much room. If you blitz, you got to get there. Russell Wilson sees the free rusher in his face and puts this ball only where Lockett can get to it, and watch this adjustment. Yep, over the shoulder. Catch for a touchdown. An unbelievable quarterback receiver duo. Okay, another great example of the Seattle play action passing game. This is why you gotta stop Chris Carson. Everybody else is jumping up. Now you see, once he gets the top of his drop, this corner, this guy right here is staying inside to protect. This safety is way too far this way, opens up this huge area. And if you give Wilson time and you give Lockett space, it's not going to bode well, and it doesn't bode well for the Tennessee Titans here. Another great throw, 5 yards of separation, and then Titans will be Titans. This is how we saw the gritty. Lockett takes this one to the house, a huge play for the Seattle offense. All right, so a bit of a wrinkle to this offense, Freddie Swain. He's taken some snaps from DK Metcalf, but he's speedy like Lockett. And in this case, you're going to see the Tennessee Titans just don't have everything quite figured out. They make a huge mistake with no one having the deep third back here. And if you do that to that guy, Russell Wilson, he's gonna find it. And this brings back some bad memories, but 38 feet away, the nearest defender, Swain just picks that thing up, takes it all the way. Another huge play for the Seattle offense against the Tennessee Titan defense. All right, this Wilson to Lockett combo in the red zone is something fantastic. Now, one thing for sure, you've got to keep Russell Wilson contained. If you let him out, you're gonna see too much space right here for him to operate, and you give Lockett the ability to pirouette and then look for open areas. Now, Russell Wilson is one of the most accurate passers in the league and one of the most accurate on the run. He doesn't miss these throws very much. He left a little meat on the bone against the Titans. Now, as we know, the Seattle defense had a hard time slowing down Derrick Henry, but it was the play action passing game that really got to him. And in this case, you'll see Jamal Adams. Now, Jamal Adams, one of the best blitzing safeties in the league. He's gonna find his way all the way inside, can ruin your day if you don't know where he is at all times. More on this later. But play action passing game. Play fake to Henry, they pick up the blitz. You get one-on-ones. A nice little head bob by the receiver opens up that whole space. Look at this, right there. Oh, doesn't come down with it. Like I said, a lot of misplays in this game. Now, continuing with the play action game, Tennessee able to exploit this all day long. Tannehill turns his back on the defense, and you see it sucks up the linebackers, and look at the space that it creates. Fires a bullet right in the middle. First down for the Tennessee Titans. A lot of room and a lot of opportunity. All right, want to see more proof? Watch this play. Receivers in, tight ends tight. Look at how much room is on this field. It just gives the receivers all that room to operate in the middle of the field. I mean, this is literally pitch and catch for Tannehill and his receiving core. And the play fake just doesn't have to be to Dalvin Cook. Here we've got a little hybrid of a jet sweep type fake. Fake to Derrick Henry. Pauses the linebackers, and you see when they sit, their eyes are on the quarterback. They're not watching the receiver get in behind them. Tannehill's able to thread that needle. Now he's marked down at the 31-yard line, but another big chunk play for this Tennessee offense. And it's not just about moving the chains with play action. This is an opportunity to hit this team deep. Again, one-on-ones on the outside. You get the play fake to the running back. Good protection for Tannehill. Again, look at all this space that's up here. And oh, by the way, watch this move by the wide receiver. It's a nice little stutter and kind of go, but then skinny the post, deliver the ball over the shoulder. Huge, huge play for the Tennessee offense. All right, we covered the play action game. The screen game is something else that's effective. Tennessee didn't run a ton of these, but with our running back, Dalvin Cook, again, off the play action, leaking everybody out. All those rushers up front, look at the space that this creates. You have the one-on-one matchups, right? You get our offensive lineman out there in space, Dalvin Cook behind him, able to move the chains in a big play. I love the screen game against Seattle. And finally, you can't forget the running game. In this case, you'll see Jamal Adams again coming on the outside. We said he could ruin your day, but when you live by the blitz, oftentimes you die by the blitz. That gives Henry all this room. Puts the foot in the ground, one-on-one, gets outside. Now this is late in the game, and all of these guys here have been covering what? Screens, play action passes all game long. A lot of miles on these legs. Henry's able to break a big one. So the Vikings finally get these Seahawks at home at US Bank Stadium. Offensively, play action screens, get those legs tired on defense. Dalvin Cook will have a big day at the end of the day. Defensively, just keep Tyler Lockett in front of you. And don't let Chris Carson get started. That takes away that play action passing game.